It's your favorite day. It's my
favorite. I need a clap first, dude.
Yes, Monday. Woo!
Woo!
Got him.
Got him.
All right, today we have we're talking about the ban list today, and then we're gonna talk some tin news and some European news. YCS Rimini, and we're gonna talk about YCS Toronto that just happened this weekend. Toronto.
Why am I even here?
Alright, so first things first is, don't even say it, but first things first, we're gonna talk about the ban list.
With everything except the DA.
Oh no, okay, before we talk about the ban list, I wanna tell you, I think 2016, 2017 might be a good season for Yu-Gi-Oh! Because, Konami updated, like, their blogs, and they actually built like, a table of contents. And, Bui, you're definitely flashing.
I'm trying to fix it right now.
Okay, but anyways, yeah. So, I don't know if you guys checked the coverage for YCS Toronto, but they have round-by-round information, and even for the top cut, I was amazed. And they had a table of contents for people to check, like, day one's news and stuff. I thought that was pretty cool. And another thing that I thought was really cool is that they shouted out shops or sponsorships. So, like, I guess they won't be making people... take off their shirts when they wear sponsorship shirts. Cause I know back then they made ARG, people who wore ARG shirts take it off. So I was like, oh, okay. What do you guys think about that? Good direction or no good direction?
I mean, it's like you gotta support your community, you know? Like you have all these shops that people know and get their news from, and it's like, come on, man, like, why not advertise them, you know? It's good for the community.
So good direction, right? I think it's
great. Yeah, it's a good
great.
Direction. Oh, also, real quick, Dennis, back to the table of contents. Europe actually does this all the time. It's just
yeah, I know. I'm saying America's. America's did it. Yeah. So I was like, oh, wow. They're like
behind on the times.
Yeah, but, you know, like, we complained enough, I guess, or it got through their heads. I don't know what it is, but it's great. I mean,
makes our life easier.
It makes John's life easier. That's all I know.
Oh, for real.
They even posted the deck that topped, you know, like, what? That's insane.
Okay, I think I fixed it.
New technologies.
The new technologies, man. It's like, they're still
using... Oh, whoa.
The flip phone. Screen.
Bowie, your screen, man.
I know, okay, I think I fixed it.
It's double YCS and Banlist is overloading the Twitch stream.
It's too much.
It's too much news, guys.
So, yeah, as people last know, last Tuesday around 4 o'clock, out of nowhere, Konami posted the Banlist. So let's go through it quick. For Forbidden, Monkey Board, and Kaiser Coliseum are forbidden. Our opinions will be stated after I discussed it. Afterwards, we have Sir, Ether, Cosmo Dark Destroyer, Magic Spectre Unicorn Kirin, Beatrice, E-Telly, Pantheism, Pendulum Call, and Stormforth as limited. Maxi, Thunder King, Wind Up to Semi-Limited. And for Unlimited, we have Thousand Eyes Restrict, Allure of Darkness, and Goldsark.
So just real quick, guys, I just want to say I was right, even though I wasn't on that stream the week before, to say right, that the ban list was going to come out after the YCSs.
Well, okay, Anthony, when you say you're right, the only other way you can be is wrong, right? So
exactly.
It's 50-50, it's a 50-50 roll. I mean, like, yeah, right?
But I was so accurate about the date, man. Like, amazing. I'm like psychic, guys. I'm the Konami whisperer.
It's still blinking, Billy. I don't know what's
wrong.
It's DevPro. It's always been DevPro.
Oh, DevPro?
It's been doing this a lot lately.
Hey Dennis, quick question. What do you think about Catacall and Burning Abyss? So actually, that was going to be the build I was playing. But we found some secret tech that, yeah, we'll see what happens at YCS Anaheim. Oh yeah, so YCS Anaheim's happening in November, by the way. Ooh. Confirmed by Roger YGO.
Isn't a new set coming out by then? It's not like just gonna change what BA
Invasion
has.
Of Venom comes out the first week of November, like that first weekend. So
it's like
Halloween's on a what, like Monday or something.
So the drama what happened with the drama is that you know how every year is always there's always a California YCS usually switches between NorCal and SoCal. Last year was San Jose, obviously, and there's always one in Seattle, right? So at first we weren't gonna get YCS Anaheim because they messed up with the contract. The contract was too expensive, so they weren't gonna have it this year. But then they messed up with YCS Seattle's contract, so there's no YCS Seattle this year.
Oh.
So to make up for it, they're gonna have YCS Anaheim. So there's no Seattle this year.
Going off of that, I recall several events in Seattle being canceled this year too.
Oh, what else?
Like, else, like
for Magic?
No, for like regionals.
Oh, regionals as well? Oh, wow, yeah. That's crazy.
So, I don't know what's happening there.
Yeah, so that's insider news. I don't know if it's true. I'm pretty sure it's true because my sources are always correct. But you know, if it's not true, don't like blame me. So YCS Anaheim should be in November. I hope in late November because I'll have time to test and stuff. Before Thanksgiving would be great.
Okay, this is the closest I can fix. But yeah, I'm going over to your opinions about what got hit and stuff.
Let's go over the first two, Monkey Board and
yeah.
What's the other one? Monkey Board and Kaiser?
Yeah.
So I honestly don't think Monkey Board should have got hit. I think it was fine at one. What do you guys think?
One card scale too strong, man. Like, come
it's
on,
searchable.
Dude.
It's one card scale. Like it, having Joker made it a one card scale. That's like,
yeah, but Joker's also
probably
at
the only reason why.
Yeah, but
I mean, they have Sky Iris.
It's like you can search into search, you know, like.
Well, I think that's fine.
Sky Iris doesn't get it.
If
Joker didn't exist, having it at one would be fine. But just the fact you can. It's like, you know, it's like you still have that consistency. It's like playing two copies.
But Joker's
at one.
You
only get one effect.
Joker's
no, but I'm saying Joker gets you anything, and it's like having another copy of Monkey Board. So you always see that
I think Monkey Board at 2 is fine as well. Do you guys not agree?
It's a two-card scale. Like, top decking it, it's just like, bam.
Without it, the deck's ass.
Again, you know?
It's pretty much, I think what they wanted to aim for in this ban list is kill consistency.
Yeah.
Because I feel like that was the main target. They wanted to cut all the decks that were consistent.
I agree with that.
So I feel like that was the only reason why they hit it. I kind of agree that Monkey Board could have stayed at one. They could probably just ban Joker instead if they wanted to stop that.
I honestly think having two Monkey Boards or two Jokers, whatever, I honestly think three Jokers, three Monkey Boards is fine too. Like, that's fine. Like, you need the deck to have a power play like that. Like, without it, it sucks. The deck sucks ass. Actually, would I have two Monkey Boards than a Joker? Because Joker's level 4. So, that's
also actually... I feel like why they did is that just the Perform Pal engine itself with having Monkey Board is so strong that, like, no one would give a care about other pendulum mechanics, or they would always pay, you know, Perform Pals. That was like
that is
know,
actually
like,
true because the
always
only...
have it. Like, now they're free to do other stuff, you know.
The but only like... other deck that wasn't that was a pendulum deck and was all right was Cleave Demise, and it's not even a real pendulum deck.
Well, if that's your argument that they want to make you not play pendulums anymore, what's the argument against Burning Abyss? They made Burning Abyss play for 2 years.
I don't know, man. Could Konami loves Burning
exception?
Abyss like?
That's like
apparently,
that's
just... it seems so, man.
It's their favorite child, apparently. Dante has dodged.
It's the next Black Wings, man.
So, is that the exception, or is that just an inconsistency?
I want to say an inconsistency.
I think having Monkey Board at 3 would have been fine, because, like, it's not... It doesn't do anything besides complete your skills, which is, like,
I think
okay.
If Joker was at 1, or was banned, or if even if it was at 1, Monkey Board at 3 would have been fine.
Joker is at 1.
No, I'm saying... He meant banned.
Oh, banned.
Banned, and then, like, he's fine at where it is now.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Because, like, Joker, you're not going to do anything with 3.
You guys understand. Monkey Board is the problem. Kieran is the problem, man.
I was going to get to that.
No, I'm saying. Monkey Board at 3
is the problem. Ignister's the problem. Kieran's the problem. Monkey Board, complete your skills is like whatever.
Yeah, but
that's my argument. I don't know.
But like, if you think about how Konami's been, they rather hit like one card that because it's hit, it makes everything else shit than like hit like 50 different cards. You know. Except when it comes to Monarch, because you know Monarch had like 10 cards that were good, so they had to hit half of them.
All right, we move on. I think Monkey Board could have been 3. It would have been fine, but. Guys, we're a democracy. No, we're not. I'm not gonna kill you for arguing with me. Anyway, move to the next card.
Kaiser, a weird choice. A lot of people questioning it.
I don't know. This is kind of weird.
So they hit Monkey Board, right? They want to make Pendulum still playable, and the answer is Kaiser. I don't have any other reasoning. They just want Pendulums to be
right. Locked. Like that's something that makes sense. You make like Pendulums really shit, so you got to make them at least be able to play now.
But no one was playing Kaiser to begin with.
Oh, it's side deck.
Was it?
Technically side decked, yeah, but I think only deck I saw. They believe pendulums are the strongest deck. I don't know why. I feel like that's what Konami was coming into. They saw the potential that pendulums have.
But like, to be honest, Kaiser was more of a side deck option for Monarchs than a pendulums, because you know, like, can't storm forth with Kaiser if you have one monster.
Yeah, exactly. That was the Cosmo side in for the Monarchs.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, guys. I'm like kind of flustered. So yeah, I only saw Kaiser in Cosmo as in, and now's when we were teching it, right, Anthony?
Yeah.
Yeah. So I mean, I honestly don't know why it's got hit. Yeah. There must be some probably thing that we don't know about.
Maybe they're just moving, you know, like trying to get all the cards. Honestly, if they wanted to hit a no play card, they should have hit Anti-Spell instead of Kaiser.
Yeah, I think there's a lot of other cards that are worse than Kaiser. Like Rivalry's really bad, Anti-Spell's really bad, Gozen Match is really bad.
They're just really inconsistent when it comes to banning and limiting floodgates, because I feel like they want to keep them in, but at the same time,
they don't.
Floodgates are just really dumb. The best solution to deal with floodgates is to have them all at three or ban them all.
Like Anti-Spell is worse than Kaiser. I would feel like pendulums can't even play with Anti-Spell up. So
maybe they did it just so that people would be like, we banned a floodgate, because they've been seeming to do it like at least ban like a couple of floodgates every like year, you know, like at least
They hit something last year. I forgot what it was.
Yeah, last year was Skill Drain and Vanity.
Oh, Skill Drain. There you go. Yeah.
Yeah. They hit the big two, so now they gotta like move down the list so that people are like, "Come on, guys, we want to play the game."
Oh, Skill Drain, Vanities, right?
Right. Vanities was.
That was a while back.
Because of Necros, right?
Yeah,
Necros. Right before Necros.
Yeah, Skill Drain, Vanities, and like Soul Drain, and
they banned the Jin.
Macro Deep Fissure.
Oh yeah, the Jin's last January. I mean July.
Yeah, but
yeah. So that's pretty good. I mean, maybe that's right. I think that's a pretty good theory that they're just trying to go down the list. Like, what's a Kaiser K? Yeah, maybe K. They're going down. So D, Dimensional Fissure. You know, K, Kaiser. You know, whatever.
They just skip the A's.
Yeah, they skip the A's. I don't know, man. Whatever.
I've read one more theory about this though.
Yeah. All right, so move on to the next one.
No, there's one more last theory about it though.
Oh,
because like it's badly designed text wise. The last version of this was like Dark Revelations Volume 1. So rather than fix it, they rather just ban it altogether.
Dude, that's so smart, right?
That's so lazy.
Right, but it's so lazy, but it's just like,
it makes sense too.
So many people you just put about that pack. Stormforth ruling.
Good, fine.
No, they passed the point of OTS pack.
Huh?
Like, I think they missed the deadlines. Like, you know what? Forget it. Just ban it.
What? There was no, like, ruling problem with Kaiser, though.
Everyone was so confused when it came to, like, Monarchs. Because people would be like, are you sure? Even though, like, you know, like, you can't Stormforth.
Control 2, yeah, but, like...
And also, like, Cosmos, like, we have a pilot and stuff.
Wait, okay, yeah. If that's the case, then I can follow you there, probably. With, you can't have tag out because it's one more monster or whatever.
But isn't that Rivalry?
It's Rivalry.
Yeah, I realized that after I said that, my bad. But,
yeah, so, if anything, you should mind Rivalry. Rivalry's a pretty broken card, too.
Either way, Konami just didn't... I don't want to have to print another copy of it.
Floodgates are just dumb.
Okay.
How about that?
Yeah, let's move on.
Come from the guy that played 3 Kaiser. YOLO, Yamato, set 5.
I used to.
those are the days, right? Those are the days.
Those are the days.
Simple Yu-Gi-Oh, man.
Tier 0 right there. Alright, next move on. Alright, so we have, let's go down, just go down one each.
Yeah, sir. That's understandable. No.
I mean, you can still do Dante loops with just one.
Yeah, Sir Beatrice at one. I mean, the deck. You can...
Like, what was it? They didn't hit Dante, so it's like they gotta hit at least Sir.
Like, it's like they like keep shooting it in the leg when they try to hit the head. Then it's DC'd.
They don't wanna shoot Dante's beautiful face, that's why.
Yeah, dude.
Like, he spent too much time on his art.
He's the Matrix. He's the Matrix man. He's the chosen one.
No, but he's like, you know the Black Knight from like Monty Python?
Oh yeah, so that
one. Oh just, yeah, just a flesh scratch. That's BA deck in a nutshell.
Yeah.
But yeah, like they didn't hit Dante, so it's like they had to hit something else to keep like the deck from like endlessly without any effort.
I think they know if they hit Dante, the deck truly dies.
Right, yeah, like, at this point, with only one Beatrice, one Sir, one graph, like, if you just hit Dante to one, like, that's it. Like,
it's like a last leg Dutch.
GG. Like, they just want it for one more format. They want to see, yeah, like, oh, man, like... triple allure BA. Let's see what if it can still work.
So, yeah, Dante and, I mean, Sir and Beatrice to one. Yeah, it looks like they just wanted to find a way to hit BA. PKBA was doing really well, and PKBA was also just Beatrice Turbo. Beatrice is a pretty broken card.
Oh, yeah, spoilers. They even won the NA YCS, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. It was a mirror match between PKBA.
Yep. No, was it mirror match?
Yeah, it was.
It was mirror match for ARG, too, lols.
Yeah, while over in Europe, Cosmos are winning.
Cosmo and Pendulum's doing better.
Pendulum, like, I don't
like
know,
the two decks you don't see here.
Yeah, I don't know. Europe Lux, they're
Cosmos. Dude, I don't know. European Pendulum players always see Fire King Island do well in their hands.
Let's call the Hanin, too.
Does it miss timing? Or does it miss the
No, they don't, activation? No, but it's like, it's just Island, you know? Like, it's not even like triple call, triple Oasis. It's just... They're playing Fire King Island, you know? So it's like, they must have, like, God combo draws or something. I don't know.
The rounds are also shorter in Europe as well.
Oh, really?
So, well, like, no, that's shorter, but, like, it's less people, so less rounds.
Oh, yeah, true. Yeah. Less time to worry about, you know, like,
going
a 10-round kill, you know?
I don't think you'll see a last of Burning Abyss. They might have, like, one more set.
They're on their last leg.
Yeah, that's what we said like last time.
oh yeah, when you were gone, Dennis. Well, yeah, that was before Beatrice, but Dennis, when you were gone, I was saying that they're probably just waiting. Like they just want one more format, and then once the next banlist comes, they'll be like, okay, bye.
Yeah, it could be. But I don't think it's gonna get Power Cube out anytime soon. So yeah, we can move the next card. Ether.
Yeah, Ether. This self-explanatory. This with Stormford would disrupt a lot of plays, even with itself with Karaz.
Yeah.
Cards I feel open. Like the deck was just too strong. Like,
I don't even need to explain
do
it.
Really interruptions.
It's not even like Ether Stormforth. It's
Ether
Stormforth, summon Karaz, dump Prime. You know, the Prime was the big thing. Like, being able to dump Prime out of nowhere is so broken.
Like, you try to do something, oh, just like Regeki. No, not Regeki. Like,
so many pluses.
I pop it, you just tag it out for another one.
Yeah. Like, one Aether got out, was that four cards? Because Karaz the Prime,
and
then you draw two.
Too.
Oh, yeah, Pantheon.
And even with Gofu now, Gofu's broken. You can Karaz your two Gofu tokens and get, like, a plus two. Broken. Yeah. So, alright, next one.
Dark Destroyer.
I think that's fine.
I'm okay. I don't know, guys, but I guess.
Dude, there's literally no comment around this. Like, if it gets destroyed, you have Call of Haunted. If it gets banished, just run more Strawman.
Everyone knows Dark Destroyer is like the fuck, man. But it's like
the card's like very poorly designed. It's like next to Ether level, you know.
You need to shuffle it back into the deck in order for it to not do anything.
I know. And if you have to like resort to that, like, come on, man, you should lose the game. All right, let's move on, dude. That's self-explanatory.
Kieran,
that's very broken. It's not.
That's why monkey board's banned, guys. Has to be at
one. I mean, Kieran. Kieran's like probably monkey ball.
Can't target it.
Yeah.
So you can't Veiler it when it activates the effect.
Yeah, that's a big thing. You can't Veiler it. Dude, that's so stupid.
So and then
bounces Eater player's turn.
Anything. So
I can't Veiler Pleiades, man. Too good.
Also, it bounces something else. It doesn't have to bounce itself. So you can bounce something else during your turn, and then on your opponent's turn, it's still on board. So you can bounce something. You bounce it. You know, it's so broken. You can bounce
my monkey board, man.
You can't bounce monkey board.
You can only bounce pendulum monster.
Monsters on the field.
Oh, if you pendulum it out, yeah, that's pretty broken play too. People pendulum.
No, like your Bambuku.
Yeah. No, also, the thing is, bouncing back your Joker.
Yeah.
And
putting it. All the
combo there you go, Joker. Yeah.
So, yeah, Kieran was pretty broke. I think it had to get hit.
Yeah, I don't know why it's not hit in Japan, but I don't know.
Japan,
I
mean, pendulum.
This thing should be banned.
Pendulum calls banned in Japan, I think.
Oh, Pendulum Claw's banned?
Yes.
I don't know. Compulse that one is all I gotta say.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, because, like, what is it? Like, the main problem with Magi Spectres is that, like, they can't set up skills that easily. So, like, now it's, like, without Pendulum Call, like, you know, the Magician Engine, and, like, here now, it's, like, what's it gonna do?
Yep. I agree. All right, next we have,
Beatrice. Let's go Beatrice.
Oh, Beatrice. I just said Beatrice with Sir.
Very, okay. We kind of discussed it with Sir, so.
Yeah. No. I mean, same thing.
Rip it's Beatrice fucking. Turbo. Itelly.
It's just Turbo. It's the.
I know. No.
Dump Sir, get Dante, and make the second Dante.
Or dump Farfar, or get out Super Dante.
Yeah, no, it's just the one where you dump Sir, get Dante back, and then you make that Dante to a Beatrice. You made a free card to 2500. So with one Beatrice, you can't do that play anymore. Your Dante's gonna be 1000. So you can't kill him on the next turn.
Okay.
So that was the point.
It's just back to F-Zero shenanigans.
Now it's just back to, like, Dante's and F-Zeros and down nerds. You can't, like, yeah, because Dante's only Dante's
so back. Sad. Dante's like, man, I'm stuck with the side bitch instead of my main. <Side bitch.
laughs> Alright, we can go
my
back.
My life was bad.
Itelly.
Itelly.
I mean, like, I guess.
I'll agree with this one. Because if Destroyer's at 1, you should put Itelly back at 3 or 2.
Yeah, like, I mean, like, Farm Girl still has to get over Dante's and Prime.
If Farm Girl still can't get over anything, so, yeah.
It's like, guys, let me over.
I need
it's
Honest like, to do
like,
something.
Like exactly. With Itelly even at 3, it's like trying to go against Donald Trump, man. Like, can't get over the wall.
Yeah.
Like, you legit, your opponent needs to have a clear board in order for you to OTK.
Itelly's now acts like a Rhoda in the deck now. Not like a OTK enabler like it was before with the Farm Girl Itelly.
It's to make sure if I open up old ships, I can at least still do something.
Yeah, you can go Straw Man into something or Tin Can or something. Yeah, I think the Itelly got.
I mean,
its role changed in the deck. So
I guess I could kind of see it since if they put it at 3 and with 3 Allure, you just like or 3 Gold Slug, you just banish whatever the fuck you want and like Straw Man it out, you know.
Oh yeah, I can agree with that then, but
yeah, but you need to run more darks.
I think it would have been fine. Yeah, it would
Gold Slug or
yeah,
or
you
that's more, true. Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, so I mean, at 2, it would make the deck like more better, you know. So you need to open Itelly and Sark, or Itelly Allure, or it's still.
Here's my theory, though.
Huh?
So this is my theory. They're bringing back Ritual Beasts, and they know Gold Sark is like the key card for Ritual Beasts.
No, but like.
But then like, they wanted to hit.
You only have one. What you call it though? You only have one Kanahawk. Like Kanahawk was the soul of the deck. Yeah.
That's
can't
true.
Do anything with one Kanahawk.
No, they're getting support though.
No, but like the support does nothing. You need you need Kanahawk, man.
Search Kanahawk. Yeah, I agree with that, Anthony. Yeah, I mean, Cosmo is still a 2-card combo. You still need Allure or plus Cosmo Town or Itelly. So now
like,
you have
honestly, like, the thing I've seen people trying to think is that like way back in the day when what you call it first came out, Delta Shuttle and all that, people tried to do a Power Well Delta Shuttle dump deck. To where you dump stuff, you dump like your psychics, and then you bring them back with Power Well, and then from there you do like crazy combos so that you can bring out like all these strongmans at once, and like go off, you know.
Well then,
so like this could happen, you know, but like I don't know, man. Especially with it can still happen because you have what is it, trains?
Oh, okay. All right, move next one.
Pantheism.
Pantheism.
So, thank God. Next.
Same category as Ether. I'm actually surprised that didn't hit Prime. So
I know, dude.
Whereas I think you could hit specific cards in that deck and those.
Oh yeah, I just
it makes me so mad that like they still have Prime, like still free.
No. Sensa, I didn't think about this, but then
you have less food.
You have less food for the Prime now.
Less food. Like Prime. I mean, Pantheism was what put food for Prime.
And also Stormforth, you bait it out.
So there's only gonna be triple tenacity now for the food.
Yeah.
Hold on, let's think about this. So you lost 2 Stormforth, that's 2 food. Then you lost
2 Pantheism.
Pantheism actually counts as 2 cards.
It counts as 0 because you used the effect of search.
Usually use it.
Yeah, you banish it. So it's only 2 cards because you search out whatever you're gonna get, and then that just goes in the graveyard. You lost 4 easy food, right?
Now you only have 1 Stormforth, 3 tenacities, and. Your domain if you play it. So 5, yeah, 5 food.
Yeah, what are
and
your tenacities going to get you now?
Huh?
Domain.
What are your tenacities going to get you now?
Return or domain.
Oh, you get 1 return, 1 domain, so that's 6 cards. 6 food.
Like, that's it.
Yeah,
it makes it so sad.
It makes sense now that they didn't, I agree now.
No, so yeah, it's a systematic hit. Like, once you hit Pantheism, their consistency dies, and their food, their ability to put stuff in the grave is also hindered.
Okay, I agree. Alright, we can move to the next one.
Benjamin Call.
Another one card.
Pendulums,
well, not one card skill.
Is all they're saying.
They're saying I had an argument with David, but like I kind of explained to David, like, oh, why is he's like, why is Pendulum Call at one? Where was that one called Melody? The Pendulum Call for Blue Eyes. What's it called?
Yeah, Melody. Melody of Awakening Dragon.
That's still at three, and I'm like, oh, well, you need Melody because without it, you can't like Alternative Dragon. You need search her. Your two piece combo.
Gonna be so dead.
Yeah. Pendulum Call, you search anything, and then you can, you know, still go off. And
then like, protection. On top of that, just protection. Yeah.
Playing Melody is like, what is it? Playing Melody is like playing, like Rhoda, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
All you're doing is bringing out one card, you know?
Yeah, it isn't like progress your game state, you would say, you know? So that's
not until the end phase, anyways.
Yeah, not to the end phase, whatever you get with it. It's your possibility.
Yeah, whatever. It's not gonna advance your plays.
That, and protecting your skills for like a whole turn is like pretty good.
Give your opponent's turn too.
Yeah, that's some things for like a whole turn, you know?
Okay.
Yeah, so you can't like, once that card comes down, Twin Twister's dead, you know? It's like, okay.
Yeah, wait, and then by the time you can get
they have one turn to go off, which is where they're safe, you know?
Yeah. All right, next card, Stormfall. I'm gonna categorize it with Pantheism. I'm gonna move on to the next card.
Maxis, now that's a real.
Maxis. I'm on my boggle. This boggles me. I'm still baffled like, as to how
people need Maxi with all the new decks coming out. Like what? Like Konami? Like
it's fine.
So this is what I'm thinking. They're thinking, let's kill consistency, right? So we don't want any more first turn Maxis. That kind of just kills first turn plays. That's pretty much the only thinking. But I feel like Maxi is one of those cards where you're supposed to play around it. Do you let your opponent plus, or do you just...
Yeah, that's the thing. It technically doesn't keep you from playing,
it punishes you one of the
for
smartest
going
cards
too
in this
far,
game.
You know? Yeah, like, right? Like,
you have
the
to
good players,
it forces opponents to make decisions. It's an interaction card.
Yeah, but it's not like Kaiser, where it's just like, plop it down. What you gonna do, bro? What you gonna do? It's I want to take the risk.
It's somewhat of a floodgate, but I still don't know why just two. If they wanted to make an impact, why not one? Why not ban it?
I think it's fine at two, because no one was playing at three.
Yeah, people play that.
People were playing at three, dude.
Yeah.
No one was playing at three. Look at any list. Yeah, no one was playing at three.
Dude, okay. Spoiler alert. The deck decks I have him at three.
All of them?
Yeah, all two of them. No, I think I'm only one of them.
Yeah, like, no one's playing because it's really...
Cosmo's different.
It's really bad right now, because why would you play in against Monarchs?
No, like okay. Because,
You just sided out against Monarchs.
Yeah, because, like, a majority...
Well, you side out for half the field. You don't play it. Like, I'd rather play Valor over Maxi.
One of those decisions. What am I playing more of?
Your logic applies to this format, though.
Yeah, but, like, it's fine. I think... You don't need it at three. It's fine at two. It's fine. I think it's fine at one, too. People still play at one.
You're going to need it at three for the upcoming format.
This
man.
Format is actually very grueling.
But
when
like,
it comes to Maxi. Like,
but like,
the top three decks will literally spam the field like nothing.
Yeah, but then will Maxi actually like stop them from doing it? They're going to kill you anyways, right?
I'm pretty sure they're running more than just Maxi, though.
Okay.
But that's the thing. Before... People will be afraid of Maxi. It's like, oh man, can I set up a good enough board to where even if they Maxi me, I'll be fine. But now it's just like, just go off, you know? No worries, you know? Nothing to care about. I don't need to worry about anything at all. I can go off freely.
It's only one card, too. Like, you guys are saying, like, oh, you won't ever see it. I mean, you'll still see it.
I'm just saying it's going to be less. You're just going to see it less first turn. That's probably the only issue. I don't really understand why, though. Like... There was probably no real reason to hit Maxi.
Okay.
We have to move on. We're already like 3 minutes in. Thunder King.
Hey, welcome back.
Cool.
Yeah.
Actually, I don't like Thunder King at two. I'd rather have Thunder King at one. I don't know. That's my opinion. Because it's like, six OP.
I don't know. Because like the upcoming decks, none of them really like inherent summon. Like, ABC doesn't inherent summon, right?
No, not
like,
that. The floodgate part. The floodgate part.
Inherent summon like crazy.
Yeah. No. But does that count when you, like, contact into whatchacallit?
Yes.
Oh, it does? Oh.
Yes. The problem is near player can add other than drawing.
The mistake effect. Mistake is broken, dude.
But, like, no one's played it in, like, forever, you know?
Mistake?
Yeah. No one played it at all the past two formats.
Because it's a trap card.
I mean, but like it acts the same way, you know. You can still get rid of them fairly easily, considering that people play Twin Twister a lot and you know like Call. I mean, not Call of the Hunt, like
yeah. So Dark why would you play
and
Mistake
and stuff? You know, like.
I think it's a really good card.
Okay, moving on. Wind Up Magician, meh.
I don't care about Wind Up Magician.
Okay, now for the Unlimited. Thousand Eye Restricted, Jack.
I think it's more, yeah, you can do the Instant Fusion play more now. You want to run two or three?
Yeah, when you run three Instant Fusions, the third one's
they're all Master Restrict now.
Because it used to be Master Restrict and Odin, but you play three Instant Fusions for consistency.
Eyes Restrict, I'm sorry. Thousand Eyes Restrict.
Yeah. Allure, Super Turbo now.
I'm scared. I mean, they're getting ready for DDDs.
Allure is like probably the best draw card in the game. Next to Pantheon.
At this point, now.
Yo, Necroface is at 3, right?
That was at 2.
Pretty sure it's at 3 again.
Get ready.
Doesn't want to banish his cards?
No, it's at 2. It's at 2, John. It's at 2.
It's at 2? Okay, I was about to say.
I did the World Banlist, John. I remember this.
And 2 Necroface? That's a little crazy.
Yeah.
Isn't Necrophage just banishes 5 cards?
Yeah, but he can. If it gets sent, you can recycle your own, not your opponent's or something.
Wait, what?
No, it just gains a shit ton of attack.
When this card is normal up, Bowie moved it.
No, Necroface.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, when it's normal, it shuffle all back, then it gains 100 per. But then the milling 5 is still really dumb.
Wait, how strong does it get?
It's okay, it starts at 12, it gets 100 per mill.
Okay, so. Like, attack don't matter, man. I can regek it. I can farm for that. I can like. I can do so much things. It can be targeted. I don't care.
All it is just you just what you call it. You pot a what is it?
Desires.
Yeah, oh you just God. Pot a desire.
You play that with Pot of Desires, and then you also run DDD Dynamite.
Okay, so you're saying burning now. We're gonna play burn. Yeah, that's very consistent.
It's very scary, you know.
No. Super hey, scary. You weren't there, Dennis.
Hey, real quick sidetrack. If you banish this with the desire, since it's face down, does it still banish the top 5?
I believe so.
Really?
I don't think so. No. It doesn't know. It's Necroface.
I don't think so. I'll check later. We gotta move to the last one because we're really behind right now. Gold Sark.
Wait, isn't it? Oh, Gold Sark? Oh.
Yeah, it's just disgusting Gold Sark.
Dragon Rulers. Oh my gosh, guys. I mean, I get a free search now for my Cosmo Town. So.
I don't know. What was that at before, too?
One.
Oh,
was that one?
Oh, wait, one and two.
It's a two, right?
No, it
was that one because of Droolers.
Only Allure was at.
Allure's at two, and Gold Sark was at one, right?
Yeah.
Sark was at one, Bowie.
I don't know.
They just decided to jump since Allure was jumping, I guess.
I'm playing Zodian now. Until you, what was it called? You Omega my arm back into my grave, I can't get it.
Okay. So, Konami Europe actually has some reasoning, but there's a minor disclaimer. So they have it here. This is from the European website. This is not from the official Konami webs. I mean, like, source, official rep. He's like a head judge. I found it on Reddit. It said that Konami, while obviously everything has been revealed with Konami, I don't have access to any information you don't have access to.
So this is just a guy saying his 2 cents.
Yeah, but he's like a judge in Konami.
Okay, I don't care. Judges are stupid. Whoa. I'd rather have Billy Brake tell me. Jeff Jones tell me why.
I'd rather have Kevin Tour tell me why.
TLDR guys, he just says it's for consistency, basically. That they just hit stuff for consistency.
Oh, no way. That's like every bad list.
Yeah, spoilers, you know?
Okay. So, yeah, that's our like 2 cents for the ban list. We could have gone for like 2 hours, but we have other stuff.
Just on Maxi.
I think it's fine.
Still baffled, man.
I have one more slot in my deck now.
You never ran 3 in the beginning.
I know, I don't ran 3. I mean, exactly. I have one more slot now.
One more slot.
My side deck, I'm sorry. My side deck.
Another Veiler, man. There you go.
Bam. I ran triple Veiler already.
Ally Justice.
Oh, yeah, there you go. Slot. Change the Maxi to Allure. Thank you, Bowie. Make my life easy.
That was John. I said Thunder King.
Oh, Bowie. So. I guess I don't know this, so I'm playing Necros now.
Yeah.
And I asked Bowie how much for Valks, and he's like 25.
Dude, that's the min. That's how I found it for.
And I was like, oh, do you want to get rid of him or what? He's like, yeah, for 25. Oh my gosh, shit.
Dude, that's the lowest price I saw on TCG Player.
That's the lowest price on Yu-Gi-Oh prices in general.
The first thing.
You don't sell me for a full price. Are you going to get rid of it or not? You can just, it's only going to do value.
It's sitting there.
Dude, I'm fine with it sitting there, dude.
Like, dude, I wish I could take 25 for my Dark Destroyers, man.
How much are they now?
I don't even know. I don't even want to check, dude.
Oh, check it, Bluey. Check it.
Dark no, don't. My eyes.
I'm gonna guess the gold series one is like $2,
and
no,
it's probably secret... a penny card, dude.
Okay, so Docs. Oh Jesus!
It's 8. Is it? Go.
So check. Docs is like $9.
Yeah, I still got it right. Let's have the premium gold.
Bucks. I'm trying to find
it. It's probably not. It's probably like
$2.75. It's $3.
$2.
Yeah, see, got it right.
Jesus Christ! Holy crap!
Let's guess another one. What else is on that list? That was
dude, Monkey Board Man is like a penny now.
Fuck, there's always a penny, dude.
Yeah, it's always a penny. What other card is there that was on that list?
I don't care.
Beatrice is probably like a $2 card now.
Oh. Yeah, it's probably a $1 card.
It's
it used to be like
very much. It's $4 still.
Oh, it's $4 still? Oh, I guess it's not. In fact, the Banlist hasn't gone into
it. No, no,
it's like it was already a cheap card to begin with.
Yeah, it was about $6, $6 to $8. The one that's pretty, I think that went up in price is Allure. Allure is now $10 combo.
Allure, oh,
yeah,
Allure Card Demise. Allures. Card Demise went up due to this.
Oh yeah, everyone with their demises can breathe safely.
Allure Ultra Rare is 24, and Allure Ultimate Rare is 50.
It's like 50. How much is
the
cost?
Holy cow. Oh yeah, Max Z probably went down in value, the ulties.
It stayed at 70.
It stayed because it's still...
It's still like Astral Pack.
And you still have two, so... It's like $70 for a Max Z.
It's 70. Alright guys, so that's it for the ban list, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I think Dennis is gonna leave, guys, so...
Yeah.
So everyone say bye to Dennis.
Don't go!
Press F to pay respects.
Thank you guys for listening. It's been a good time, and
we're still going. Just Dennis has to do stuff.
Yeah,
have to go study. QQ. All right, guys. Have a good time. Don't yell at Bluey too much. Okay, bye.
I'm gonna yell at Bluey all the time.
Okay, so moving on. So if people don't know, like some of us didn't, Megatins actually come out this Friday.
So, can't believe it.
Yeah. So some keynotes. Some cards have been revealed. This is mostly from a French eBay account. I have no idea what is it.
Wait, really?
I Games Avenue Pierce. No, because like the mass. This is like a mass quantity, right? So this is based off all what they pulled so far.
Oh, okay.
Because I've only like there's like 26 secrets and there's only like 10 listed or something.
Okay, because I thought I saw a list circulating.
Yeah, people... I saw that list too. That's not complete.
Okay. I thought it was complete.
So some secrets we know are coming out. Clear Wing, not to be confused with Crystal Wing, that's the 8. Galaxy Cyclone, Jar of Avarice, All Eyes Rebellion, Tatsunoko, All Eyes Vortex, Scarlight, All Eyes Fusion, Painful Decision, Painful Escape, that's the trap card. Buster Blader, Solemn Strike, a lot of people going nuts for that. Ultimate Providence, Infinity, and Rafflesia.
Yeah, so the cards people hope for to get reprinted are, of course, getting reprinted, so people buy it.
Yeah.
I thought that should have been obvious.
Yeah. But, you know, news is news, man.
In terms of what the secret super ultras are, lose a turn, something I'm eyeing out. Bambuku is questionable due to the fact he's at 1 now. Ignite Reload, still good for Pendulum decks. The Atlantean Prince, water, still water. You drowned.
What?
You drowned, dude. In terms of Super, though, Melody is actually a surprising reprint. We just got that in
Melody,
common.
What?
It's a Super.
Oh, Awakening Dragon. Oh,
yeah. We just saw that for OTS Pack 2, but another reprint wouldn't hurt for the players. It does hurt the value, but if you picked it up, you picked it up. Utopia Prime, of course, we see this in the Utopia combo, where they either nuke the field or have more materials for Utopia. Full Armor Photon Dragon, again for Blue Eyes. Zengshi for Pendulum, if you still play it. Brilliant Fusion is actually getting reprinted, so we might see more of that. DDD cards, you want to pick it up. And my favorite, Twin Twisters.
Oh yeah, dude, that Twin Twister reprint and Brilliant Fusion reprint, that's actually pretty good for budget players.
Yeah, so again, just comes out this Friday. Good luck in your pools. We might have some on sale under Project YGO. I'm not 100% sure.
We are for sure.
Okay.
You just gotta check out our eBay, Amazon.
Oh, message us on Facebook on under Project YGO. More details. Let's talk about our sponsors quick, actually, because next is YCS.
Yeah, so while Bully gets us ready, I talked about our sponsors. So if you guys do want anything from the tins, just hit us up on our eBay, Amazon, or TCG player. For eBay and TCG player, you can find us as Project YGO. For Amazon, it's Project YGO TCG. So just click on those links down below to find out what we're doing. We actually pre-sell some certain things on our eBay. So we might actually have some of the promos for sale. Maybe just mega, the mega packs in general. Just check us out. Shout out to Ultimate Guard and Ultra Pro, because you know those are like the best products in the game right now.
Oh, shout out to Ultimate Guard again for like the new like matte thing that looks pretty sick.
Yeah, it looks really sick. Also, shout out to Costco where the cost is low, because you know munchies and stuff. And that's it, guys.
I'm looping this song. Oops. So YCS, there's so many events that happened this weekend. Two YCSs in the Brotherhood. Due to time restraints, I can't talk about the Brotherhood Open that was hosted by Lintheo. You can check out his archives. He had it. Pretty great duelist. It was duels all around. But let's go to the main events. YCS Rimini happened last weekend in Rimini, Italy. The venue is some sort of spear-looking thing.
Pretty cool-looking.
Yeah, they had 894 duelists plus 12 late entries. I don't know if that means that's like 900-something, or that's just included in the 894. Like most European events, if not all European events, it was streamed. In terms of the inside venue, it looks really normal. That dual carnivals? We had several giant cards. Two of them featured in this picture is Utopia the Lightning and Cypher Dragon. Lightning, if people don't know, this is where people confirmed that it was being the promo for the Dark Illusion Special Edition, as you see in this corner right here. And before people ask, you can't play these in real duels. Because, like, Galaxy Eye says you can use it, but then doesn't say for Lightning. Don't do this to me right now, guys. You have this banner. Also, a quick note about YCS Rimini. They had a special aerial for YouTubers recorded. You might see in Lintheum's videos. He did a lot of coverage for it. Shouts to him. Vendors. For some reason, they had a statue of Utopia. The regular Utopia. I don't remember having that happening in any other YCSs. Statesides, though. Yeah, that's the venue. In terms of who won the giant cards, we have here Nicholas Zax winning the Utopia the Lightning using Domain Monarchs 5 rounds. He went 0-2 in the main event. Some other random stuff about him. Sunday's where all the other giant cards were. I'm gonna butcher a lot of these names. I'm sorry if you're watching this and that's your name. With Ebon Illusion Magician, we had Jack Eagle from UK using PK Fire, aka Burning Abyss Phantom Knights. The winner of the Galaxy Eye Cypher Dragon, we had Marcus Birchen from Germany using Kirin.deck. Yeah. We have here Utopia Kaiser, won by Long Dao, strong duelist, European duelist. Yeah. Well, from Austria using Pendulum. Silent Magician was won by Fleerat B from Germany. And Nirvana Hyde Paladin was won by Imran Khan Jadul from Germany. So, using BA. Congrats to them. They got giant cards. Like 500 a pop.
That Silent Magician is really nice.
In terms of the public playoff events, we had Alfin Egan winning a Kaiser, and Alberto de Castillo Steely winning the other Kaiser. In terms of Dragon Duels, though, top 8, we have Alice L, we have Leonardo C, who's this? La Copozi. Gabriel L came in fourth. Oh, sorry, they had one more, but he wasn't there. Nicola M, he got top eight. Third place, we had Matteo G. Second place, Matteo Z. Is that a common name in Europe?
Matteo?
Yeah.
I'd like to say yes.
Wasn't that a neat character in Red Ball?
I wouldn't know.
Never mind. And Matteo M winning. Wow. So he won. Congrats to him. He got his playset of Dark Lords, which might be valuable in the upcoming months. Okay, in terms of the actual duels, though. Give me a sec. Let me change this quick. Main event. We saw 108 Domain Monarchs, 82 Phantom Knight Burning Abyss, 70 Burning Abyss, 66 Cosmo, 65 Blue Eyes, 63 Pendulum, and 34 Metaphors, and 418 others. In terms of the country breakdown, yes, I snapshot this from YouTube. What of it? We had 568 players from Italy, 144 duelists from Germany, 41 from France, 28 from Austria, 11 from Switzerland, 9 from Netherlands, 5 from Spain, 4 from Slovenia, and 88 other. In terms of top 32, though, we had 5 Pendulum, 4 Domain Monarch, 3 Cosmo, 2 PKBA, 1 Cyber Angel, 13 other deck. Two of these decks include a Klee Demise and a Lighthorn deck. John, can you read out who got the placings?
For top 4?
Yeah. Oh, stop at second, though.
So, 4th place was Leonard Nena. I actually don't know what deck. 3rd place would Federico Santagati.
Again.
2nd place was Tayfun Beyraktar.
Yes. So he was playing a Pendulum Magician deck with Desires. He's from Germany. I got this deck profile from Lynthium2300. Shouts to him. Quick note, this was his first YCS and he got 2nd place. It was almost the dream. So he's playing Pendulum. He played triple Dragon Pit, 2 Oath Dragon, 1 Jiangxi, 1 Wisdom Eye, 1 Dragon Pulse, 1 Joker, 1 Monkey Board, rest in peace, 1 Mammoth Splash, 1 Odd Eyes Unicorn, 2 Pendulum, Odd Eyes Pendulum Dragon, 3 Magical Abductor, 2 Bumbunku, triple Kirin, 2 Apex Avion, triple Terraforming, 2 Sky Iris, a Odd Eyes Fusion, 2 Summoner's Art, triple Pendulum Call, 2 MST, 2 Paw of Desires, and Upstart. Extra Deck, Totem Bird, Dweller, Castell, Trapeze Magician, Utopia Beyond, Photon Bouncer, Strike Bouncer, Norido, Ebon Illusion Magician, Red Eyes Flare Metal Dragon, Red Eyes Absolute Dragon, Big Eye, Odd Eyes Rebellion Dragon, Odd Eyes Meteor Burst Dragon, and 2 Odd Eyes Vortex Dragon. Side Deck, Triple Chaos Hunter, Triple Max Lee, 2 Radiant, 1 Time Sword Magician, 2 Cosmic Cyclone, Secret Village, and Triple Typhoon. Oh yeah, so long story short, he lost because game 3 he was like triple terraforming. It's like, it was really bad. Like, triple terraforming, I think, like a spellcaster's in like no playable skill or something. It was bad. You have to watch it. Some quick notes. Thanks, she's to stop Beatrice. Through the monster effect, once per turn during your player's turn, you can target one land monster in the field, negate that face up effect to stop the dump, but it does not stop the floating. Just heads up for people.
Dragon effect Veiler.
Yeah. Dragon Pulse to stop the floodgates. He actually said that Mammoth Splash was better than a third Apex Avion. You can search with Joker. You can make your hands better because the Pendulum effect pretty much makes it a fusion. You can fusion. Oh wait, Pendulum or Monster effect? The Monster effect. During your main phase, you can special summon one dragon type fusion monster from your extra deck using monsters you control as fusion material. So he can do that. What else? 2 Bumbunku, because 3 is kind of... there's a really big dedication to normal summoning, and you might lose if you run, you see all three. Paul Desire is an amazing build and upstart. Extra deck was pretty self-explanatory. Side deck, Chaos Hunter was for the Monarch and Kozle matchup. He opted to run Radiant other than the other Kaijus, because with this he can actually crash with Vortex Dragon. Vortex Dragon will proc, getting him either Meteor Burst or Absolute, depending on situation. Timebreaker was actually for the Bude matchup, specifically Blue Eyes Spirit Dragon. Due to the monster effect, when this card is Pendulum Summoned from your hand, and no other cards are Pendulum Summoned at the same time, you can double it, whatever. The other part though, once per turn, you can target one monster in the field, banish both it and this card, but return them in your next standby phase. So you have to make them either tag out or make them... Regardless, Spirit Dragon is going to leave the field. Secret Village for the Blue Eyes and Monarch matchup. He knows it's no longer for the mirror because the abundance of Bambuku everybody's playing and Typhoon's card. So any other thoughts, guys?
There's a pretty interesting side with the Time Sword, but other than that and the Mammoth, this seems like a pretty standard list.
Yeah. John?
I think Pot of Desires is what gave the deck its consistency. That's pretty much it.
That helped him game 3 at the finals. That was the most depressing finals I've seen.
I mean, like, that's gonna happen, right? It's funny, because you'd think something like that would happen to the Cosmo player.
Yeah.
But instead, it happened to the Pendulum player. Sweet, sweet revenge, guys. Sweet revenge.
So yeah, congrats to them, second place, but that's not first place. First place, Alberto Conti playing Fire King Cosmos from Italy. I got this from actually Jolly Roger's YouTube channel. I believe they're a team in Europe. He's part of them. Before I say anything though, I want to go off the consistency thing. How everybody in the US is playing BH just for consistency reasons. And here they are topping with this stuff. So going through it quick, triple Dark Destroyer, one Forerunner, one Landwalker, triple Slip Rider, one Delta Shadow, one Dark Lady, triple Sword Troopers, a Cosmo Farm Girl, a Straw Man, triple Tin Can, triple Maxley. Oh, he was running it! Grunix, triple Cosmo Town, a Fire King Island, triple Terraforming, two E-Telly, Upstart, two Allure, triple Cosmodrill, and triple Call. For the extra deck, F-Zero, Levier, Breaksword, Grampulse, triple Corbage combo, aka Brilliant, Giga Brilliant, and Corbage. Vogasaurus, Gaia Dragon, Pleiades, Infinity combo, side deck, triple Good Witch, Regeki, double Dark Hole, triple Twin Twister, triple Effect Veiler, and triple Anti Spell Fragrance. Quick notes, Trooper's best card. If you go at max C, you have to play more traps, because the Fire King, as you know, they have to do a special summon to go off, so at least as a backup plan. A crazy thing he said, I don't know if I heard this right, but he said he sides out two Tin Can if he's going second.
That makes sense, because, you know, you want your combo pieces.
Okay. Extra deck, Carbage, we're going second with Island combo. Also, Fortress out Beatrice, like, if they try to far floor it, you just make another one. Side deck, Good Witch going, Good Gang going second, of course, against Floodgate monsters like Vanities. You're the Cosmo expert, Anthony. Can you explain more about this?
Yeah, so, like, I only saw the main deck part. I actually didn't see the extra, because I was just like, plain old list, right? But this triple Corbage engine is, like, really amazing, because, like, as a Cosmo player, like, getting around Beatrice and Prime is a really hard task to do, and, like, for me, I personally didn't play Fire King Island when I went in ads, but, you know, I had the Corbage combo just because, like, you know, like, I had it even though I couldn't make it. Just because, like, oh, man, I wish I could have been able to play this and do it so that I could get rid of those wall cards. And, wow, just, like, seeing how... No wonder he did so good, just because the fact that he focused so much on Trooper and making Corbage. So, like, if you're going second, and, you know, everyone, BA and Monarch's always going to set up their walls. So this is a good way to use the deck while going second. Because, you know, normally going first to Fire King Island, you do the Infinity combo and just, like, set up like a Dark Destroyer or like a Wicked Witch. I mean, not Wicked Witch, a lady. So, like, just having a really good way so that you can keep on progressing your game state by clearing your opponent's board and going in with, like, you know, that farm girl for more damage by using the Corbage engine was a really smart thing of them to do. And think, like, in the video there's like 10 guys saying that they, like, all thought together to build this list, and you could really see it just by playing that triple Corbage. That and was it the three Good Witches is also a pretty good card, just for the fact that you force out that far foot play in, like, the B matchup, because Corbage here says you just target a defense position monster, so it doesn't have to be face up, so you can summon Good Witch and try and force out that Beatrice if they try and do anything, and you know, you just tag out, go into something, you know, simple Cosmos stuff, right? So having that Good Witch there is like something that Cosmo needs, but just to force things out was pretty smart of them to do and actually consider. And then, like Boo was saying in the video, them thinking about when they're going second, take out the tin cans, because I remember in the video they said that they had played three tin cans just because of the fact that they wanted to play this whole trap lineup. If they went first, that if they got Maxi, you know, doing the combo, all you need is an island, Cosmo Town, and like a ship in hand. So if you say Maxi them, they were able to hopefully have that tin can in hand as well, just to be like, okay, I'll stop my combo, I'll just do tin can plays. So this overall is actually probably like the best Fire King Island build I've ever seen.
Fairly missed.
Yeah, I mean, like, yeah, it sucks, but you can still play. I actually think Fire King Island gets a bit stronger just because of all the draw cards and the searching. Oh, yeah, okay. But having three Dark Shores made the deck easier to pull off. But yeah, this is going to be different for Cosmos. Not too much different. I can still see Island, and middle foot Cosmos will probably be played more just because that didn't focus too much on Dark Destroyers.
Okay, so first place, again, congrats to him. Now moving on, statesides.
Sort of states.
Oh, sorry, you're right. The Western Hemisphere?
Across the seas we go.
North America, the Americas, how about that?
Yeah. Oh, Canada, an era is coming to an end.
Mexico doesn't count anymore, according to Konami.
Oh, yeah. So, yeah, YCS Toronto also happened this weekend. So, it was pretty much the last event. They had several duelists such as Billy Break, Tyler Kinsley, Bo Tang, Chris LeBlanc, Aaron Furman, Morden Tamek, Justin Dillhorn. I've never heard of this. The last couple people I haven't heard of.
Dillhorn? Ha.
Yeah, so let's go quick. A good thing about this event, they had the bounty system. For people who don't know what the bounty system is, basically there's several duelists that has like a bounty, which is like several cards. I mean, sorry, boosters. So at the start of each round, four booster packs will be removed from the bounty duelist initial. They get like four, I think. They start with four to the bounty pile. If he wins. If the bounty wins, he receives two packs from the pile. If he loses, though, you, the Lewis, will receive all the packs in the bounty pile. The longer the duelist goes undefeated, the more packs you might receive. So let's say he won round one, there's two. You beat him round two, you get six packs. If he's undefeated the whole day, though, he gets all those packs.
So basically, you have to win YCS. Or when the
day one,
without you have to make it into that day two in order to or you have to just top day one.
Yeah,
they just gotta do good, man.
Yeah, do good. Don't scrub out.
Yeah, which is it's not too much.
It's
of
hard
a
to for to these keep pros. The packs. It's easier to lose the packs, but it's very hard to keep the packs.
As
it's
like gambling, as a bounty,
because like. Think about it. If you go nine rounds, and then day one, seven rounds, and then the eighth round, you lose. That guy gets to keep the packs. That's just dirty. Round.
That is true. You got to go 9-0 or 8-0. Well, Toronto was 8-0.
Yeah, it was 8-0. So.
But to be fair though, these guys, they're just pros. You know, they're not there doing it for the packs. They're doing it there for the fun. That's why Konami approaches them to do it. Like players like Billy Break, who's done it multiple times at different YCSs. So it's like, it's just, it's like rewarding players for being really good players, you know? I don't think the good players even care about getting the packs.
No, I'm just saying like, it's hard to keep the packs.
Yeah.
In terms of giant cards, we had Paw of Desires and Coral Dragon, both cards from the Dark Illusion. We have here a AV Joshua Petrov winning the Paw of Desires. And I believe this is Roland Fang winning the Coral Dragon. It doesn't say. Quick reminder though, this is the new regional map, the Ebon High Magician. You get it from topping your nat. I mean, sorry, your top 8 regionals, I think? Or is it first place?
At regionals, it's top 8, I think.
Regardless, you want to aim high. What else? The new prize card, of course, is Utopia Kaiser. We also have the top cut mat for top 32. That's actually a pretty sick looking mat, in my opinion. Before we talk about the other stuff, let's talk about the public event playoffs. For point playoffs, we have Stefan Silverman winning one of the Kaisers. He looks familiar. I think I've seen him before, but I don't know where. We also have a Jasper Juan. One? Yeah, Juan. Taking the other one from the random playoff. In terms of Dragon Duelist, Saturday, we had Airboy's favorite Project's favorite duelist taking first place. So we have first place, we had John Wilkins. Second place is Ryan Yu. Third place, Martin Wu. Fourth place, It Sang Kang. So they didn't mention Sunday. Sunday we had Connor Joseph Perrotta taking it, but the overall winner was John Wilkins playing Klee Demise, I believe. Yeah, it was. So congratulations to him. We were gonna see him again at Nats. We just saw him do really well at Worlds. The future's bright for this kid. That was corny.
Next hoping, right?
So unfortunately, I don't know the overall amount of participants or deck, but what I do have is top 16. So we had 5 BAPK, 3 Burning Abyss, 2 Domain, 2 Fire King, 2 extra deck, 1 BA Monarch, and a surprise Uranus Monarch.
I can see that.
Yeah. Top 4. Fourth place, we have Alexandre Delpe with the main Monarchs. Third place, Ryan Levine, extra deck Monarchs. Second place, Michael Walters, PKBA. And first place, drumroll. First place right here, Bolden Temenak from Australia taking it. We just saw him at Worlds again. I believe he got second place in his nationals in Australia. It's gonna be weird seeing him play in Nats here.
Did he move?
No, I think he's on vacation.
That's funny. Probably not gonna play Nats here then. He's probably gonna play Nats.
No, he has the opportunity.
Oh yeah, you can just say both. But you can just play in Australia.
Yeah. So you see their Xbox Ones, their PS4s, congrats. I didn't see any deck profiles at the time of this recording. So yeah. That's gonna be a weird format. Like we saw like the three BA topping, Kozlo topping. They're both Konami US exclusives. It's gonna be weird seeing them out like rotated out.
Well, I mean, BA isn't really rotating yet. Cosmos are kind of hard to judge because I don't know how amazing Cosmos are going to do against ABC.
Yeah.
ABC is a really good deck.
Yeah, with only one Dark Destroyer, I think Dark Destroyer was like the only thing that could get around ABC. Because ABC still targets, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, but then they can just make Utopia for Lightning.
Yeah.
That's how they typically did it. They just equip Utopia the Lightning with what's it called? The one that banishes Rhapsody in Berserk. And then they just crash over the Cosmo Dark Destroyer.
That's some salvage sounding stuff. But yeah, congrats to them. We're gonna be a new era. The Banlist starts as of today. Get practicing like I tried. Don't play Blue Eyes. That stuff's bricky.
Blue Eyes.
No, you should play it in the month that it's strong.
Blue Eyes is just useless right now. Cause what is it? When our regional comes out, is ABC already
gonna? No. We have to October 1st. We're gonna miss it by like a week or two.
A week? Oh man. But we get to play with it at one event, guys.
Shut up. Well, yeah, that's it for today. I just found out Kevin Owens just won the championship. Congrats to him. Dun dun dun. Any last words?
No. Cosmos will forever live on, guys.
Alright, see you guys.
Bye.
Later.